Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're gonna be walking everyone through the EM Test LD200N, which you'll see in front of me right here. And this is that automotive load dump or clip load dump generator. So today we're gonna walk through a little bit about the front of the system, showing you some of the connections as well as some of the buttons on the front. Following that, we'll turn it around. We'll show you the different ports and different connections that you can make along the backside. And then finally, we'll go ahead and we'll start up the software, the Iso.control software. We'll show you how to modify some different testing parameters as well as selecting different pre-programmed standards. All right, so let's go ahead and let's get a closer look at the front here and we'll walk through some of the different connections there. Okay, so we've just taken a little closer look at the front side of our EM Test LD200N. We're going to go ahead and start from our left side over there. You will notice a number of keys underneath the display. Those are going to be your function keys. Today, we're really not too concerned with the display because we're going to be using the Iso.control software to modify some different testing parameters. You will see a turnstile here as well, as well as additional keys. As I mentioned before, we're really not too worried about those if we're using the software. You will see your test on button. Following that, you'll see your trigger and your device under test supply right here, or your DUT supply. One other thing you will notice down here at the bottom, this is going to be your EXTRL. This is going to allow you to do some testing for Ford, both the FMC 1278 as well as the CS 2009. Okay, so that should just about wrap the front. Let's go ahead and we'll turn the EM Test LD200N around and take a look at the backside. Okay, so here you're going to find the backside of your EM Test LD200N. There's a lot of different connections on the backside here. However, we're only going to focus on a couple that are commonly needed. Let's go ahead and start from our left side here. You're going to find your ground. Following that's going to be your test supply in. Kind of working on right here, you're going to find your trigger. Following that, you're going to find the power going to your EM Test LD200N, as well as your power switch. On this side here, we're really most concerned with is going to be your Ethernet connection, which is going to go right here. And that's going to go towards the computer using to control it with that Iso.control software. Okay, so now let's go ahead and let's get everything plugged in and let's start up the software and show you how to modify some of those testing parameters through the software. Okay, so all we've done so far is connected our EM Test LD200N to our laptop. That's going to be using your USB interface port. That's just going to go to a USB drive. So there's a couple different things we're going to touch base on here. We're going to split this up into kind of two sections. The first section, we're going to walk through setting up communication using your Iso.control software to your EM Test LD200N. The second one's going to be modifying some testing parameters as well as running through some standards. Okay, so one of the first steps you're going to want to do is go to Setup and Device. And this is just going to allow you to actually enter the devices that you want to control with this Iso.control software. So taking a look here, there's a number of different devices you could have. We're only going to have one active today. So you want to go ahead and select the device you want to add. So for our example today, we're using the LD200N. Then you're going to go ahead and provide the license code. This is going to be with the USB drive that included your Iso.control software. So after you plug it in, you can load the software, and you just enter that license number right in here. Following that, the serial number, and then finally is going to be your interface. So as we mentioned earlier, today we're using USB, so you want to be sure that the associated port is selected there. All you have to do for that is just click on the RS232/USB button, and then select OK. All right, so you'll see that all the information is provided there, as well as the software number and okay. All right. And then we're going to go ahead and show you one more quick thing you do want to be aware of. Under Setup, go to General. You'll notice a whole wide variety of different options here. However, what you do want to focus on is Mode. So there's two different modes that are commonly done. That's going to be a simulation mode, which is software only, versus the test system itself. So when you're actually trying to conduct testing, you want to be sure the test system is selected. And when you do turn that test system on to that mode, you will notice the display says remote on it. Another thing you will notice as well is in the lower right-hand corner, you will see LD200N indicated down there as well. Okay, so that should be just about it with the setup. Now let's go ahead and we'll stop the video quick and then we'll start walking through the standards as well as modifying some testing parameters. Okay, so now that you got your EM Test LD200N and your Iso.control software communicating, we're to go ahead and show you how to select different standards for testing, as well as modifying some of the pulses. Okay, so let's go ahead and start with the two standards. You'll see that under the modes. And we're to go ahead and go to select standard. And today we're going to go ahead and look at ISO. So that's going to be international standard right there. And go down to ISO 16750-2. Okay, so you will see that up top as well as the revision history. So this is obviously revision 4. We're looking at, for this example, we'll just keep it at 24 volts. And you will notice pulses right here. This is the final section. These are the different required pulses. So for our example today, we're using the EM Test LD200N. So we're not able to provide these pulses with this generator, so you will see them grayed out. So if we click on the pulses that the system can provide, you will see that some of the criteria is grayed out as well. And these are required by the standard, and so they cannot be modified from this setting here, from this menu. So we'll go ahead and we'll talk more about that in a second. However, when you are ready to begin testing, all you have to do is hit this start button right here. All right, so now let's go ahead and go to two devices. This is going to allow you to modify some of the most common pulses out there. That way you're able to meet some different testing criteria. So let's go ahead and we'll take a look at pulse 5. And here you can see a couple different criteria you can modify. Let's change that to 83 volts. And we'll just go ahead and change this to 17. And then if we want to go back to the default settings, all you have to do is hit the default option there. Okay. There's one more thing we want to touch base on quick, and that's going to be the freestyle mode. So if we click on here, it should be right at the bottom under functions. It's going to pop up your freestyle mode menu. This is just based on the load dump pulse, and it does allow you to modify some of the criteria a little more than you would be able to otherwise do through, let's say, the standards menu. So you can modify that there. I want to change that. Just change the rise time and duration. And then let's say we want to save this pulse. All you have to do is save it right here, and you can change the comment, use me, and then save it in the appropriate file. And then obviously, similar to that as the two standards, when you're ready to begin testing, all you have to do is hit the start button right here. All right, so that should just about it. We appreciate everyone's time. Feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions or if you're ever in need of any rental EM Test LD200N low dump generators. Thank you.